Now let's create the beams of the ground floor. As it happens with walls, visual beams can be created either following straight paths or from any curves. In this case, we are going to choose the first option, but we will need to first show everything in the model. So we run the beam command. We can select some insert options, for example the style, in this case the rectangular one, and some dimensions for the this existing style. There are some sizes already defined, but we are going to choose other and set any custom value. We're going to set 20 centimeters for the width and 25 for the height. Finally, we are going to choose the top middle alignment. So, if we check the project, we will be able to snap onto the right point. Beams also have control points that let us stretch them in any direction, so we can select this grid point and move it from this hip point to this point. And same for the end point. Now we can make two copies of this beam. And we can create another one joining these two columns. So I run the beam command again. The last settings chosen are remembered by VisualARQ, so I can just snap onto the center. Let's try again. Finally, we will move this beam endpoint next to the other beam edge.